Welcome back to your free Windows 7 training course. In this video, I will look at the free tool available from Microsoft called the Application Compatibility Toolkit, otherwise known as ACT. For the 70-680 exam, it is beyond the scope of the exam to go into too much detail about the toolkit, but I will cover the basics. So far, I have looked at how to configure compatibility options on a single computer. If you are supporting an enterprise network, you are not going to want to configure each computer individually. The Application Compatibility Toolkit is a collection of applications to help you run old software on Windows 7 when you are running in an enterprise environment. The toolkit is a free download from Microsoft. The main tool included is the Application Compatibility Manager. This tool allows you to collect information from your network about what applications are running and what compatibility problems you may have when upgrading to Windows 7. This tool does require that you have either a SQL Server on your network or the SQL Express Edition installed locally. The next tool is the Application Compatibility Administrator. This tool contains a collection of fixes you can apply to allow old applications to run under Windows 7. The next three tools are more aimed at the developer. If you want to check your websites to see if they are compatible with Internet Explorer 8, the Compatibility Tool includes the Internet Explorer 8 Compatibility Test Tool to test your web pages. The next tool, the System Analysis Tool, can examine existing setup programs to see if there are any problems running them on Windows 7. Lastly, there is the Standard User Analyzer Tool, which looks for problems with your user account control. User account control is the system that displays windows, such as these, asking your permission to proceed. Some applications and installers can have trouble working with user account control. Let's have a look at how to install and use the Application Compatibility Toolkit on a Windows 7 computer. First off, you need to download the Application Compatibility Toolkit from the Microsoft website. I already have the web page open. You can find it easily using a search engine. On the website, there are also a number of documents you can download that will help you use the Application Compatibility Toolkit. To use the toolkit, however, all you need to do is download the setup executable. In this case, I will save it to the desktop. Since I do not have a SQL Server on this network, I also need to download SQL Server Express. This is a free, scaled-down version of SQL Server. I have already opened the web page for the download in this tab. This web page is easy to find using a search engine. Once I select the download link, I will be taken to a website in which I can select the language for the installer I want to download. Microsoft has supplied a download manager to download this particular file. The download manager will be able to continue the download if the download is interrupted. Once I have downloaded the file, I can close all the Internet Explorers and run the SQL Server Express setup I saved to the desktop. Once the setup has started, I can select the first option to install a new SQL Server on this computer since I do not have SQL Server already installed on this computer. Next, I need to accept the license agreement. Once past the license screen, I will be taken to the component screen. In this case, I will accept the default components. For the rest of the install, you can accept the defaults. Once I have accepted all the screens in the wizard, SQL Server will start to install. The process takes about 10 minutes or so, but I have sped up the process. Once complete, I can close the wizard for SQL Server. Now that SQL Server has been installed, I can run the setup program for the Application Compatibility Toolkit. The installation is a simple one. The only option you can set is where to install the program files. Now that the Application Compatibility Toolkit is installed, I can run my first tool. Remember that the Application Compatibility Toolkit is a collection of tools, not just the one tool. To collect data from the network, I need to run Microsoft Applications Compatibility Manager from the Start menu. The configuration wizard will start on first run. You will notice that once past the welcome screen, I have two options. The first option, Enterprise Configuration, is grayed out because the program was not run with administrator rights. You will notice how the wizard gives you the option to launch itself again with administrator rights. Once I select this option, the wizard will run again, and this time I can select the option Enterprise Configuration. On the next screen, I can select the SQL server that I want to connect to. In this case, I will select the local computer. I will also need to create a database, which I will call ACT. Once the database is created, I can move on to the next screen and select a share for the computer on the network to which I wish to save data. On this computer, I have the public folders shared out, so I will select one of them to save the network data. Remember this. This computer will collect compatibility data from other computers on the network, so the computers on the network need to be able to access this share. Next, I will select an account under which the software will run. That's it for the wizard. Notice by default the tick box Send ACT Usage Data to Microsoft is ticked. This is statistical data Microsoft uses to help improve the product. If you do not want to send data to Microsoft, you can always untick the tick box. Once I complete the wizard, the computer is now set up to collect data from the network. It is beyond the scope of the exam to go into too much detail on how to set up this application and collect data from the network. However, if you had been collecting data, you could select Analyze and view the reports about the data that has been collected. At the top are the reports for Windows 7 clients. This will show you which applications on the network do not work with Windows 7, applications that have minor issues, and applications with no known issues. Down at the bottom of the screen is also a section for devices. The tool has reports for Windows Vista computers with Service Pack 1 and Service Pack 2 installed, and finally Windows Vista with no service packs installed. Using this tool, you can view problem applications on your network and hopefully correct the problems before you upgrade computers. The next tool in the toolkit is the Compatibility Administrator. Once I open this tool from the Start menu, I can see a list of known fixes for applications. When you have a program that crashes, if you have selected Take Part in the Microsoft Customer Improvement Program, this data is collected in a file and periodically sent to Microsoft. This information is used to generate this list of fixes. By selecting any application on the right-hand side, the fixes that need to be applied to that application to work correctly under Windows 7 are shown. If I select a different application, for this application to work correctly, it needs to be run as an administrator. Also, below this, there are some other fixes that need to be applied for the application to work correctly. If there is no fix for your application, you can create a custom fix called a shim. If I close the Compatibility Administrator now and go back to the Start menu, go back to Application Compatibility Toolkit, and select Developer and Tester Tools, I can run the tool Internet Explorer Compatibility Test Tool. Before I can start using this tool, I need to select the option Enable at the top of the screen. Once selected, I can then open Internet Explorer. With Internet Explorer open, down at the bottom of the screen, you will see an icon showing that Internet Explorer is logging compatibility information. All you need to do now is to open any website for which you wish to test compatibility. Once you have all the information that you need, close Internet Explorer and go back to the Internet Explorer compatibility test tool. Here you can see the issue types that were identified with the web page and running with Internet Explorer 8. Hopefully, using the tools that I have shown you in this video and the last video will help you to get your applications to run. Even with all the hard work that Microsoft has put into getting applications to work in Windows 7, some applications may still not work with Windows 7. To fix problems like these, Microsoft has introduced XP mode. XP mode allows you to run your applications in a virtual Windows XP machine. XP mode is the topic of our next video.